So we went down, and it was a big dramatic stage with all the Ames standing there with their looking really macho with their, but they had poles, pipes and things, and they were standing guard. After we got in the building, we found that there was no one negotiating any place. So I said, well, do you have someone that you've talked to that you can negotiate with? And I'll help you. We'll see if we can use Fred's office and help you set up the meetings.
But then when we started talking, then a fight broke out in the back. The police tried to charge the building. The
cops had decided to storm the building. There was a lot of stuff being thrown around inside and table legs used as clubs and stuff like that. And the cops were attempting to come in some of the lower windows, and the guys were down there beating them back with those table legs.
They pushed the police back. The police then regrouped and they left. And they came back with about 40 more police officers. And they tried to rush the building again, but there was people upstairs up on the second and third and fourth stories, and they all had big typewriters. People were coming in like that, and they were throwing those typewriters and deliberately in front of the police to let them warn them that if they get too close, that's what's going to happen.
When you're in a situation like that, you can begin to get fairly paranoid in terms of, they're really going to come in here and beat the hell out of us, so we have to defend ourselves. Sort of a siege mentality that developed within that.